हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज टॉपिक इज रेडियो एक्टिविटी। ओके, तो व्हाट इज रेडियो एक्टिविटी? द डेफिनेशन ऑफ रेडियो एक्टिविटी इज दैट द डीके, ओके, अंडरलाइनिंग दिस वर्ड, द डीके मीन्स डिसइंटीग्रेशन। ओके, द डीके ऑफ एनर्जी एनर्जी और पार्टिकल from an element. That means if the element is radiating energy or radiative particles, means it's a element, energy is coming out or particle is coming out. Okay, in the both cases I will say this is radioactive element and the process is radioactivity. So now the question arises, if the dust is a radioactive element, then what happens? Okay, what happens in radioactivity? The emission of particles happens, right? So if it's a duster, I will see after few days it will disintegrate 50%, and after few time, it may be up to years, it will totally disappear. So one thing is happening here, the materials, the particles are decaying, okay, and decay means disintegration, losses are happening. So basically, who shows radioactivity? Now the nucleus, who are unstable in nature, they show radioactivity. Now question arises, what is the meaning of unstable? How do someone will know that instability and stability means, what is the basic difference between unstable and stable? So unstable nucleus, there is a ratio, neutron to proton ratio. If they both are equal, then this will be 1:1. So up to 20, there is almost neutron to proton ratio is same. Beyond 20, you will find somewhere neutron to proton ratio is not same, more number of neutrons are there. And in case of more number of neutrons are there, the ratio is not 1:1. So if it is not 1:1, if the neutrons and protons are not same in number, then the instability is coming into picture. I can say for stable nucleus, the ratio have to be 1:1. For you, this much information is sufficient. For nucleus to be stable, the neutron to proton ratio have to be 1:1. So those elements which are unstable in nature, they only show radioactivity. And types of radioactivities, basically three types of radioactivities, alpha, beta and gamma. That means, if I am saying alpha radioactivity is happening, then what is the case? If I am saying beta radioactivity is happening, then what is the case? If I am saying gamma radioactivity is happening, then what is the case? I will discuss three one by one. So first come to alpha radioactivity, alpha decay. First come to alpha decay. What is an alpha decay? Alpha decay is that, what is an alpha? It is 2He4, okay? That means alpha is nothing but He2O4. So it will get decay. So take an example. Suppose I have taken uranium, okay, which is 92-238. I will say an alpha will get decay. Alpha means what? 2He4 will get out of this. That means the new will be 90, because the 2 is getting subtracted, 234. It is the thorium. So basically it is looking like a chemical reaction. So what is this? Is the reactant side, this is the product side. So what happens? The reactor is breaking down and two products are obtained. It is simply for you to understand that, sir, this is the left side, this is the reactant, is getting divided to two products. Okay, so how is this division occur? We don't know, but we can say that this have emitted one alpha particle. If I say it have emitted two alpha particles, then what will happen? Two alpha particles means another 2He4 will be there. So now this 92 will be 2 plus 2, 4 will get deducted, it will be 88, and here 4 plus 4, 8 will get deducted, it will be 230. So this will be another element. So the question arises, so what is the exact meaning of alpha decay? So I will say, if a radioactive element is lossing, so what is lossing? An alpha particle. Then it is an alpha decay. Okay, and you know alpha particle is 2He4. So then alpha decay is over. So beta decay, how will you remember what is beta decay? In beta decay, I will say one electron is lost or one positron is lost. So you haven't heard about positron. So you think it as a process, okay? Positive electron. And this is only encountered in this nuclear physics effort. Okay, till now we haven't heard of positron. So what is an electron? What is a positron? So if I will say sodium, you know sodium? Okay. It is 11, it is 22. So if I will say it is undergoing one beta decay, the new product will be 10, but no change in 22. No change in 22. Only this will be 10. Okay, so one only electron is getting lost. One electron is getting lost. It is beta decay. If it will be positron, then what will happen? Then this 11 will be. And if a positron will get evolved, then this 11 will be 12. And 12 and this 22 will remain same. Okay, only the electron is, you know that na? This is what? Z. The Z is what? Number of electrons. If electrons is getting decreased, the Z number you have to simply decrease one or increase by one. So two types of decay alpha, one is electron decay or positron decay. If electron decay is occurring, then you have to reduce Z by one. If positron is emitting, you have to increase Z by one. Simply I can write a standard formula. Once I will be discussing the three decays. And last is gamma decay. Gamma decay is what? Gamma decay is, it is saying, if it is X, atomic number is Z, atomic mass is A, it is going a decay, whether it may be alpha decay or a beta decay. So some product is getting, okay, suppose it is going alpha decay, so what is the product? X is there, Z will be Z minus 2, A will be A minus 4. So this is the product after the alpha decay. So experiment shows that, many experiments shows that if it is also beta decay, then what will happen? If it is a beta decay is happening, then what? If it is a beta decay, then A will remain as it is, X is Z will remain as it is, Z will be Z minus 1 or Z will be Z plus 1. Depends upon the types of beta decay. They will mention whether a positive beta decay or negative beta decay. So suppose it is a negative beta decay, so I have taken Z minus 1. Okay. So now I will say what is a gamma decay. So experiment shows that these are highly unstable and always they have a tendency to go to their ground state. And you know, if an element will go to the ground state, the electron will go to the ground state, you know, you have studied also, energy will come out. So in this state, what happens? Energy is coming out in photon. That means after some radioactive process, the unstable nucleus try to go to the ground level. And in this process of transition, energy is emitted. You know, if a transition is occurring, energy is emitted, and the energy takes the form of photon. That means light is emitted. That means lighted energy. So gamma decay indicates that in radioactive process, definitely light will be there because energies are decaying, so energies are emitting in terms of photon, and you know that photon is light, nothing but light. Okay. So these are the three types of decay. you have to remember alpha decay, beta decay and gamma decay, and you have to take one more example. I have no example for gamma decay. You have to write only two lines for gamma decay, one example for alpha and beta. The formula is that if X is there, which atomic number is Z, atomic mass is Z, is going alpha decay, the product will be X, Z minus 2, A minus 4, simply. If I will say 2 alpha decay, you can do easy. 3 alpha decay, 4 alpha decay, 5 alpha decay, you can do like this. 1 alpha decay means 4 will get distracted, subtracted, and 2 will be subtracted. Then, same is the case. If X is the element, Z is the atomic number, A is the mass number, if it is going beta decay, then no change in mass number, only change in atomic number by 1. These two important things you have to remember for alpha decay, for beta decay. For gamma decay, you have to remember simply definition. No need to remember anything. And what is definition? In gamma decay, the unstable nucleus tries to come to the ground state, and in this process, energy is emitted in form of light. Okay, so now we will come to very important derivation in this chapter, and this is the only one derivation in this chapter. So that is law of radioactivity. Law of radioactivity. So what is the law? The law says that the disintegration means what? Disintegration means, suppose I have taken an element which amount is n. N amount of element I have taken. So after certain time, I am dividing with T. After certain time, I am finding. So what is the law of radioactivity? You have to remember in one line. Law of radioactivity says that the rate of disintegration input directly related to the amount of substance. Amount of substance means what? Suppose thousands of atoms are there. So today I am observing in the whole day 10 atoms have disintegrated. So tomorrow again I am observing 5 are disintegrating. And tomorrow, what I am observing tomorrow means the initially I have 1000 number of elements. So I am observing integration number of elements who are going away, who are integrating, is 10. And in certain time. So very next time I am observing there are 500 of elements are there, and here I am observing 5 are integrating in that particular time. So after some time I am integrating, I am encountering 200 elements are there, then this number is decreasing. That means what? The more is the original amount, the more will the disintegration. Day by day what will happen? The amount will be reduced, and accordingly the disintegration will be reduced. Means if it is 1000 number of elements, in 1 second I will say 10 number of atoms are disintegrating. If it is 500, then that 10 number will be 5. I am taking an example. In 1 second only 5 are disintegrating. If the amount will be 200, in 1 second only 2 elements are disintegrating, means disappearing, means leaving this parent atom. So what is this? Now this is the integration, disintegration, and this is the original amount. That means if original amount is increasing, this is also increasing. So a question comes, arises. I have taken 2 samples. Okay, sample A contains 2000 number of atoms, sample B contains 3000 number of atoms. So my question is that they both are radioactive element, then in which case the disintegration will be faster or will be more? So for 3000 case, the disintegration will be more because the number of elements are more. For 2000 element, the disintegration will be less. So this thing is represented by a single equation, and that equation is the disintegration is directly related to the original amount. If it is more, then integration will be more. So that means you can say, sir, the atom, sorry, for the case B, if in 1 second, if you found the 100 hundreds are disintegrating, for the second case, in that particular 1 second, you will find somehow less than 100. It may be 80 or it may be 70, but less than 100. Here is the 100 is the disintegration number, here is the less than 100. So we are getting, what is that? It is the amount of disintegration. It is nothing but it is the counting. Suppose 3000 nucleus is there. After disintegrating, the number of nucleus will come into, will decrease, will gradually come into decrease. So from this I will derive the radioactive equation. So what is the radioactive equation? So minus del n upon dt I can write as minus dn by dt. So you will ask questions, sir, why minus? Because disintegration is happening. Disintegration means loss of matter. Slowly, slowly matters are losing. Okay? Slowly, slowly matters are losing. So as it is a so now let's have a look over here. Why I am saying minus dn upon dt? Because it is losing, matter are getting disintegrated. So minus dn upon dt directly relates to what? N. So are you getting my, why I am writing minus? Okay. So I will write like that. Dn upon dt equal to lambda n. And I will take that minus n to that side. So now I will write dn. I will bring this end to this side, so it will become lambda dt minus is there. So now I will do the integration. Okay, do the integration. If I will do the integration, I will take it as n0 to n. You have the question arises that how to choose the limit. Limit is what? N0 is the initial amount. N is the amount present over here. Means if I have taken n0 amount initially of the radioactive element, after disintegration, now n is left. N is left from N0 initial amount, now N is there. Okay. So it will come as Dn upon N and taking integration of minus lambda, I am taking out dt, integration of dt again T0 to T. That means initial time was T0, now time is T. So what I will get from this integration? I will get log of it is log n, answer is 1 by n, 1 by n dn. Integration of 1 by n is log n, and putting upper limit minus lower limit, that means what? Log n minus log n by log n 0, log a minus log b, it is what? Log a by b. So I can write log n by n 0. Very good. Okay, this side is done, equal to minus lambda t minus t 0. Okay, so now from this equation, I will write it. If this T0 is what? Initial time. If I will stay initially, time is 0. Means now I am starting my calculation. So I will take initial time 0 and that this will become, okay, log of n minus n0, n upon n0 equal to minus lambda t, simply minus lambda t. So if I will, I want to delete this log, but I will do anti-log, okay, it is a mathematical concept, here I will do another log, okay, then what I will get, simply n upon n0, just remember like this, n upon n0 equal to e to the power minus lambda t I will get, exponential will get multiplied and lambda t will get raised to the power of that, and which is nothing but n equal to n0 e to the power minus lambda t. So it seems quite difficult, but in this step you have to remember how I am doing. Exactly these are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It is very, very difficult as compared, very, very small thing as compared to long derivations in mathematics. So don't get panic. So in this step, finally I am getting n equal to n0 e to the power minus lambda t. It is a very important relation and known as law, known as equation of radioactivity. Equation of radioactivity. So what is equation of radioactivity? That means if I have taken n0 amount of initially n0 amount of substance I have taken, after a time t, lambda is what? Lambda is disintegration constant. lambda is a constant, na? This constant mark after this proportionality sign I have used lambda. Lambda is a constant. It has to be given everywhere. Then what is the disintegration constant? And what is the time? So question will be come like this. Suppose you have taken 5000 atoms, 5000 number of elements, nucleus. So angel is 5000. After one day, time is given 24 hours. Lambda is given. What will be disintegrated and what will be left? Left is value this much. So after one day, time is given. I have originally taken 5000 nucleus. So n will be remaining. So this calculation will say after one day and the original value is given. So how much will be left? How much will be left? How much will be left? Suppose it is coming as 3000. That means what? 2000 have disintegrated in one day. So this is very important relation you need to remember, which is known as equation of radioactivity. Okay, equation of radioactivity. Then I will move to very important factor. Another important factor, half life period and average life period. So before describing half life period and average life period, let me discuss about what is it, half life period. So if I will say this is a radioactive element and number of nucleus is 5000, so after how much time the number will be 2500? Suppose 5000 nucleus are there, so now it is 2500, now it is 1250. So what happening is that half is disintegrated. So from 5000 to 2500, the time required is T half. I can say it is the half life period. Then it is another half life period. So what is the meaning of what is the exact meaning of a half life period? The time needed for disintegration of 50%. So what is the equation? I got the equation is n equal to n0 e to the power minus lambda t. This is the equation I got. Okay. So from this equation I am going to derive the half life period. Half life period means the time for 50% disintegration, 50% disintegration. So what is the what will be condition? My condition will be, I will name as t as t half. T half. This will be t half. So now one thing is for sure, if at t equal to t half, originally I have taken n0 and left is n, and what is left? That is half of the n0, because I am going to derive the half life period. So that means n is n0 by 2. N is n0 by 2. So I can write n0 by 2 equal to n0 e to the minus lambda t. So n0 by 2 is cancelled out. So if I have to take 2 to that side, this side. So it will become e to the power minus lambda t equal to 2. So again I will apply log. Why I will apply log? Because log e is 1, I will for the convenience of my solving, I am applying log. So it will become simply minus lambda t. So now what is happening? E to the power lambda t equal to 2. So applying log, I will get simply lambda t. Log e lambda t, log e will be 1. Log e will be 1, so lambda t equal to log 2. And this t is nothing but t half. So this is t half. So log 2 value is what? So I will take as t half equal to log 2 value is 0.693 upon lambda. So simple expression I am getting. Okay, in problem they will ask what will be the half life period of the element whose disintegration constant is 0.17. So a constant is given whose lambda is 0.17. Then what is the half life period? Half life period will be simply a calculation. Suppose you are getting 24. So you will say 24 is the half life period. That means it may come in 24 hours or it may come in 24 days. So that is separate. So simple calculation is there. You have to do a simple calculation for half life period. It is known as half life period. And another derivation is there, which is a task for you. You try to do it, otherwise I will do in a next video. The average life period. And what is average life period? Average life period is what? Suppose I have taken 5000 number of nucleus. I'm observing the first second. In observing first second, one is disintegrated. And in the very next 5 hours, another one is disintegrated. And the next 10 days, another one is disintegrated. So I don't know. It is a very spontaneous process. So when, what will happen, I don't know. So what I'm observing, for one nucleus to disintegrate, it is 1 second. For the next to disintegrate, it is 1 day. For the next to disintegrate, it is 1 year. So the times are not certain. So what to need, I need to calculate the average life. Okay, average life. The average life is what? Average life is what? Summation of the total time. Okay, suppose for first one, it is 5 seconds. For second one to disintegrate, it is 2 days. Or for third one, it is some another time. So different times, I will simply add the total time and I will divide the n. So there is also a 3-step derivation which you have to derive. And I'm writing only the formula, average equal to 1 upon lambda. So this is the very much two important formula for the radioactivity law, that half-life period is 0.693 upon lambda and T average equal to 1 upon lambda. So in the very next class, I will do certain problems on this radioactive law. Thank you.